it really kind of wobbles.
So there's a very easy way to fix this slight amount of footscape. We go to add mocap fix, maintain position at frame, and that's the type of fix we add. Post retarget fixes are very, very similar to Blender constraints in terms of the interface, and also a bit in terms of what they do. You can show or hide it, you can change the type, you can change its name, which is mainly just a feature for you. You can turn off if you want it to be active or not, or you can delete it. So the first thing we want to do is we want to eliminate this amount of footscape. So we want to freeze the maintain position at frame fix, can also be known as the freeze fix. We want to freeze the toes position in this range of frames. That is from frame around 42 to around, let's say, 97. So, 42, 97. Smoothing is how many frames you want to blend in to the new position and blend out. 10 is usually a good default. Sometimes you need less or more. It's a good thing to try. But 10 is usually is a good default. And the space you want the fix to be in. We want to use world space for now, because that's how you fix footscape. We want it to maintain its position in the world, regardless of how its parents or armatures are moving. So the last thing that we want to do is kind of pick the bone we want to fix, which is toes.r. As you can see, it kind of snapped right there. And now there's absolutely no amount of footscape if we recalculate the path. You can see that for this entire length of frames, the tail doesn't move. And then it slowly smooths out. So if we kind of zoom out now, we can see that that small amount of footscape has completely vanished. And you can go ahead and do the same for all the animations. So there are other types of fixes. A more general type is the maintain position fix, which just simply allows you to kind of lock a bone's position in space. This is useful. Again, you could use this to eliminate footscape, but the freeze one is easier because it just takes the position of the start frame. But this can be useful especially because with the different spaces. That is, here it's an object space. You can see that the leg is always keeping its position with the armature. If you have a hand, if you have some type of object, this can be used for a subject carrying a box. Maybe you always want the box to be in front of him, so you want his hands to always be in front of him and not move. Another option that's very useful is the other bone space, which uses the bone 2 option. So if we go, for example, and we choose toes.l, and this fix takes a while to calculate, you can see that now the two bones kind of stay together the whole time throughout the range of the fix, which is 0 to 100. This can be useful for various reasons. Now it's 5 Blender units away. It's useful to sometimes edit the motion capture data in this fashion with a few automatic fixes rather than going in and modifying and manually editing. Especially when it comes to the way the armature interacts with the environment. I mentioned carrying a box, etc. Another way the armature can interact with the environment is through the floor, which I'll show you. And we're back. What I want to show you now is another post retarget fix, which is the stay above fix, or you could think of it as the floor fix. It's similar to the floor constraint in Blender, just a little more clever. And here we have a situation where we want the straight walking animation to traverse a terrain that is a little bumpier than just a straight line, and we get this artifact where his leg goes through the floor. So we're going to fix that by adding a stay above. Now you can notice that I've added IK constraints to both the toes and the foot during the retarget process. For this type of fix, it's useful to have constraints on both. Otherwise, the foot can go through the floor and the toes won't, and vice versa. You kind of have to set fixes on both. So, stay above. So we'll define a mesh, which is just plane. And we'll define a range, which is the entire range of the animation, basically, I think. I mean, yeah, pretty much. And we want to define a bone. So let's kind of start with foot.all. So foot.all. Now this constraint, excuse me, this fix takes a bit of a time to calculate because it's it needs to raycast. Now you can see that it made the foot bone go a little higher, but because while the bone might be right on top of the plane, the bone might be right on top of the plane in the correct position, the mesh isn't. And we can just fix that by setting here a small offset. Let it recalculate. Okay, that was a bit too high. This fix is a little slow because we're raycasting within Python for the entire range of the frames. But yep, that's already looking a little better. We can see that there's still a little amount of the mesh traversing the floor. But before we try and fix that by increasing the offset, we can also add the same type of fix to the toes. So toes.all, range of 500, plane. Let's set the same offset. Alright, now it's still going through a bit, so we're increasing the offset slightly. And that's already looking pretty good. You can obviously continue tweaking it. And it also, of course, baked the position of the next foot plan. So by using that, you can ensure that your objects don't go through the floor. The reason why it's called stay above, because at this point, it only works in the global Z-axis. If there's enough demand, that can be changed if you want characters walking up walls or something like that. But there was another way to edit the way your character walks, and that's through path editing, which I'll be showing in the future. It's part of the extra mocap tools.